Everyone! So, for today's topic, ang pag-uusapan naman natin is kung paano kayo makakapag-apply ng tourist or visit visa going to Spain. So, if you are someone that always been dreaming na makapunta sa Barcelona, sa Madrid, or sa kung saan mang part ng Spain, this is the right video for you. Now, let's proceed dun sa mga steps na gagawin nyo. Step by step procedure kung paano kayo mag-a-apply ng tourist visa at saka ng visit visa. So first, you need to go to the embassy website. I will have the direct website of the Spanish embassy on the description below. So go to that website and then look for the checklist under the visa category that you will be applying. So again, click nyo yung tourist at saka slash visit visa, and then lalabas doon yung complete checklist ng mga requirements na kailangan nyong ikompleto. Now, if nakita nyo na yung checklist, the next thing you need to do is to complete everything. Again, guys, kung ano yung nasa checklist, make sure you have everything. Or in some point, you might need to submit more than what is being required dun sa checklist. So, ano nga ba yung mga standard requirements for tourist and visit visa? Again, guys, for tourist and visit, halos magkapareho lang yan ng list of requirements. Nagkakaiba lang sila for additional requirements that will be coming from the inviting person or from the sponsor. Yun lang yung pagkakaiba. But the rest, halos pareho lang siya. So, the first one is kailangan nyo ng long brown envelope. Not all the embassy require this. Some embassy just require you to go to the embassy and then submit your requirements. Hindi na nila kinakailangan na i-folder pa, hindi na nila kinakailangan na ilagay pa sa envelope, sa clear envelope or brown envelope. But with Spain, they're very specific that you need to put all your requirements and the long brown envelope, and the requirements need to be arranged based on the arrangement dun sa checklist. Hindi pwedeng random things lang nakalagay na, okay, sing it dun sa envelope. Of course, if you're someone, or if you are the consul, or if you are the, what they call that? Yung service, anong term yun? Ikaw yung tagatanggap ng mga requirements, syempre, ang sakit sa ulo if tatanggap ka ng envelope with random, with all the papers na kung saan-saan lang siningit. So, help them make it easier, help them pabilisin yung process by arranging the documents already. Just arrange it kung paano siya nire-request sa checklist. And for those documents that are not in the checklist, kung saan nyo siya sa tingin dapat included, or kahit sa pinakahuli na lang, since hindi sila kasama dun sa checklist, dun nyo na lang ilagay sa pinaka last part. Next requirement is a completed and signed Spanish visa application form. So in most cases, you can have it downloaded in the embassy website. So you will be able to have a chance na sagutan siya online, and you don't need to be worried of paying anything because the application form is free. So if you wanted to know where to download it, again, go down on the description below. I have there yung pinaka link para ma-download nyo yung application form. The third requirement would be a two photo ng ano, pinaka recent passport size picture. Make sure na clear yung picture, kita lahat. Kumbaga, alam nyo yun, pag kumuha ka ng passport, diba kailangan yung buhok nasa likod ng tenga, kailangan wala kang banks, kailangan wala kang accessories. So, pag magpapapicture kayo, sabihin nyo lang yung para sa pag-a-apply ng Spanish or ng visa. And then, ayun, basta kung ano yung requirements for the passport picture, ganun din yung sa kanila. The next one is, of course, one of the most important requirement is your passport. So yung passport and copies of your previous visa. So yung passport, make sure na at least valid siya for 3 months from the day na magre-return ka after your trip, and make sure na merong at least 2 blank page dun sa passport nyo para dun sa mga upcoming travels nyo. Guys, make sure yung passport, you will be able to photocopy yung front ng passport and then yung page where your information is written, yung kung nasan yung picture nyo, yung information ng passport nyo, so yung baliktaran na page na yon. And then lahat ng stamp dun sa passport nyo, if you're a frequent traveler, so yung mga stamp, yung mga visa, lahat yon ipa-photocopy nyo. If hindi kayo frequent traveler, wala kang kahit anong stamp, this will be your first time to apply for a visa or first time to go abroad, then of course, wala kang ipapakitang ibang stamp. But beside the front page, make sure to also have a photocopy nung back page nung passport nyo, yung page kung saan merong nire-request na signature, at saka dun sa passport is yung contact details, ng parang emergency contact details. So yung part na yun, yun yung ipapa-photocopy nyo. Also, please don't forget, if you're someone na meron ng mga old passport or you've been renewing your passport for like 2 times already, please bring all your old passport with you during your application. Hindi nyo na siya kailangan na photocopy. You just need to bring it with you. Kasi they might need to look into it para tingnan yung mga travel history nyo. But if you do not have it anymore, it's fine. Hindi nyo na kailangan dalhin talaga. But it's a good thing na madala nyo if meron kayo. The next requirement is your flight itinerary reservation with dates and flight number, specific entry and exit in Spain. Again guys, yung return ticket at saka yung ticket going there. Again, hindi ko nire-require, hindi ako. I mean, buong embassy, they always suggest not to buy the real ticket if you're just going to apply for a visa, since they cannot assure if they can provide you a approve visa, since it will all depend talaga sa mga requirements nyo. So during the application, it is best that you will just get a dummy ticket or a ticket reservation under your name. So if ever ma-approve kayo, then that's the time to buy a real ticket. At least nakasave ka ng money if ever ma-deny ka. So if you're don't have any idea or you wanted to know more about dummy ticket, I do have a separate video to that. I have it in my channel, so look into that, or I will just have it in the link up here. And then you would also need a complete travel itinerary. So magkaiba yung flight itinerary sa day-to-day itinerary. Yung flight itinerary is the itinerary regarding your flight. And then yung travel itinerary is your day-to-day plan. So make sure that your travel itinerary will be convincing, meaning doable siya. It means pag gumawa ka ng itinerary, kapanipaniwala na yung itinerary na yun is kaya mong gawin. Marami kasing dito nagkakamali na when they do their own itinerary, they do research, yeah. Nag-search sila sa Google na things to do in Spain or things to do in Madrid, Barcelona. And then they just write it down randomly sa mga dates na to without thinking of the distance from one place to another. Kailangan guys, consider nyo, baka naman merong day doon na naglagay ka ng 5 tourist spots na ang lalayo naman sa isa't isa, and it's impossible to be able to visit those tourist spots in one day. So make sure na convincing yung travel itinerary nyo and doable, at saka it will match also your budget. Baka naman ang mamahal ng mga pinili nyong tourist attractions and activities, and hindi naman enough yung money or yung financial support nyo. So medyo magiging complicated kayo pagdating doon. If you need help making an itinerary, if you wanted to know what format you can use, again, I have a video on how I do my itinerary. If you need help or if you want me to do your itinerary, that is also possible. I do have a website, and then check nyo lang yun. Andun lahat ng mga services na in-offer ko, and I can do your itinerary. Then, Next requirement is a travel insurance. It's very important na meron kang maipakita na accredited insurance from an accredited insurance provider. So, regarding kung ano yung laman dapat ng insurance nyo, ang pinaka-importante lang talaga is make sure na valid yung insurance sa Spain and valid siya sa lahat ng Schengen countries. So, I would suggest to get an insurance with Standard Insurance, AXA, or Pacific Cross. Pwede kayong kumuha online or pumunta kayo sa mga office nila. Next, a cover letter stating the purpose of your trip to Spain. This, ang daming hindi gumagawa ng cover letter. And then at the end, they will be asking bakit sila na denied. And when I asked, can I see your cover letter? They did not make one kasi daw wala daw sa checklist, hindi daw required. Again guys, hindi lang sa Spain to, kundi sa lahat ng countries sa Schengen and sa lahat ng visa category. It is very important that you make a cover letter kahit hindi siya i-request. Kasi yung cover letter nyo is the only way for you to be able to communicate or for you to be able to explain your situation, your intention sa consul na magre-review, na magde-decide whether they will approve you or not. So the more convincing your cover letter is, the more na mapapaliwanag nyo sa kanila na talagang ito lang yung intention nyo, then the higher chance that your visa can be approved. Kasi minsan, there are times na kahit lahat na provide mo na, you have everything, you have good strong ties, you have a good job, and then you have a lot of money in your bank, but then you forget to make a cover letter. There are times na yung consul, hindi niya maintindihan which is which. So minsan, na-overlook nila yung application nyo and then they denied you. And then, pag nag-appeal ka, all you need to do is make a cover letter and then they approve you. So, to save time, to save effort, in the first place, gawa na kayo ng cover letter. Watch my other video regarding cover letter on ano yung mga dapat laman ng letter nyo, the format, ano yung arrangement, everything is on that video. Next, proof of accommodation for the whole duration of the intended stay in Spain. So, ito na yung mga proof na meron kayong tutuluyan. There are different types of accommodation. So, for tourists, if you're someone who's applying for a tourist visa, you can either show hotel bookings under your name. Pwede rin ng hostels. At least, makakasave ka kasi lang money, especially if you're a single traveler. Tumatanggap din sila ng Airbnb booking at saka yung mga apartment. Kaya most of the time, ito yung mas mura kesa sa hotel. And then, if you are someone that is applying for a family visit or friend visit visa, make sure that you have an invitation letter from the inviting person, from your family and from your friends. Also, you would need a invitation letter from the Spanish police. So, magkaiba yung invitation letter coming from your friend or family dun sa invitation letter na manggagaling dun sa local police kung saan nakatira or saan registered yung family or friend na pupuntahan nyo. Next, make sure na beside dun sa dalawang letters na yun, meron kayong mga supporting document coming from that inviting person. Tulad ng passport niya, resident ID or yung DNI para mapakita na resident or like legally living, staying yung inviting person niya sa Spain or yung tinatawag namin na empadronamiento. Empadronamiento. Ang hirap i-describe. So, ayun. And then, ayun, list na ng mga supporting documents, proof that you're in relationship with that person, either picture together, or if he's a family member, make sure to attach a marriage certificate or birth certificate. And if wala kayong mga picture together, pwede rin po ang screenshot ng mga chat conversation nyo. So, I will have a list of the supporting document for the inviting person under the description below. But again, to make sure that you have everything, make sure to check additional requirement on the checklist no tourist and visit visa. Next requirement would be the proof of sufficient financial means. So, kailangan mapatunayan nyo na afford nyo mag-travel. So, it's either your own money or someone will be supporting you. So, if you will be covering your all expenses during your trip to Spain, make sure to show a bank certificate or itong certificate na to kailangan i-request nyo sa bank nyo kasi kailangan siyang may stamp and signature ng official ng bank and kailangan bago siya, so maybe request it a month before your visa application. And then you would also need to show 6-month banking statement. There are times they might request for 1 year. So, I think it's best mag-request ka na sa bank mo ng 1-year bank statement. And then, pagpapasa mo sa embassy, just submit a 6-month statement. And then, at least if they said, okay, ma'am, sir, ano po kailangan? 1 year. At least ready ka. Hindi ka nababalik pa. Kasi there are times, ako ganun eh. Hindi sa Spain, but sa Netherlands. Nagpasa ako noon 6-month statement and then they change it to 1 year. So, kailangan bumalik pa ako sa banko ko. Anyway, so if you are someone or if you do not have enough money to support your expenses, kasi mahal, you can also have a sponsor if someone is willing to sponsor your trip too. Next one is your proof of civil status. So ito ang mga certificate. Marriage certificate, birth certificate, if you're someone na divorced na, divorce certificate, or if namatay na yung partner nyo, you can also show death certificate ng spouse nyo. So, make sure lahat yan galing sa PSA. Next, you would need to show proof of will of return to your country after your visit. So, this can be yung mga employment contract, declaration of your employer. If you have any children, you can also declare that. Or if you have parents na inaalagaan, mga senior citizen, mga parents na ikaw na lang yung nag-aalaga, pwede nyo silang i-declare as family ties at saka reason for you to return to your home country. Now, there are a lot of things, guys, na pwede nyo ipakita as strong ties. Minsan, hindi kung ano lang yung nare-request dito, hindi lang yun. You might have something, you just not sure kung ipapakita nyo ba yun sa embassy. So, to help you decide whether something you have is yung pwede nyong isubmit as strong ties, recently, I do a video of all the things na pwede nyong gamitin sa strong ties. And if you do not have one, ano yung mga pwede nyong gawin to be able to have one? Kasi hindi pwede, guys, na wala po akong ganito eh. Walang-wala talaga. So, paano na? I mean, hindi ko rin alam. Hindi ko alam kung anong gagawin mo pag walang-wala na. Kasi pag walang-wala talaga, the embassy will be having a hard time deciding whether to approve your visa or not. Kasi you need to prove them na babalik ka ng Pilipinas. And to be able to do that, you need to show them something. So, again, look at my previous video about the strong ties and dun lahat ng pwede nyong ipakita at ano yung pwede nyong gawin to be able to have something. Next, evidence of employment status. For employees, you would need employment contract o yung tinatawag natin na COE, current bank statement at least 6 months, payslip from the last 3 months. So, if wala kang bank account, pwede mo gamitin is payslip, yung latest 3 months payslip. But if you have both, better to show both. Then, of course, pinaka-importante, if you're someone that is employed, leave permission from the employer. Again, if your employer does not approve your vacation, 50-50 chance na approvean ka ng embassy. Because why will they let you go on vacation if your boss is not letting you go on vacation? So, medyo mahihirapan kayo dyan. I know sa Pilipinas, very rare ang pinapayagan magbakasyon, especially for 3 months. I've been there. It's so hard. So, next, another important, very important actually for those people that are working, is yung income tax return. Of course, the consul wanted someone that is responsible in paying tax. But I know in the Philippines, na mayroong mga exempted sa pagbabayad ng tax. So if you are exempted, please do mention and explain that sa cover letter nyo. Now, for those people that are self-employed, make sure you have DTI, barangay or mayor's business permit, company or your own bank account statement and statement 6 months and then bank certificate and again income tax return. If you do not have income tax return, if ang business mo is maliit na business lang, it's okay as long as the annual salary is less than 250k. Good to not be paying tax, but if you're earning more than that, kailangan nyong magbayad ng tax, kailangan nyong nakaregister sa BIR, and if wala, again, explain sa cover letter nyo. Again, guys, the key is, anything na wala ka, anything na hindi mo mapaprovide, anything sa mga requirement na may reason behind kung bakit wala ka noon, maiintindihan lang yan ng console if you have it explained sa cover letter nyo. So do that. And then, for student, make sure that you have proof of enrollment, approved letter of absent from your school or university, and then a photocopy of your school ID. And lastly, if you're someone, a retiree, senior citizen, just show a pension statement for the latest 6 months. If you wanted to see yung checklist ng mga requirements that I just mentioned, I will have that in the description below. Now, let's say that you have everything, complete na lahat ng requirements nyo, labis-labis pa kasi meron kayong mga additional requirements. Then, you are now ready to set an appointment sa embassy. Now, ang Spain embassy is not under BFS. Meron silang sariling visa outsource partner. And ito yung tinatawag na BLS International. So, under BLS International, dun kayo magsaset ng appointment. For the direct link para makapag-set ng appointment, go in the description below. Once you have your appointment, approved na siya, all you need to do is go to that approved date. Now, you would need to submit your application sa BLS International. Personally, hindi pwedeng ibang magdadala niyan. Kung sino yung applicant, siya yung magdadala. Once you will be submitting na yung mga documents nyo, yung mga application nyo, yun din yung time kung kailan kayo kukuhanan ng biometrics. After the biometrics, pag nabigay nyo na lahat ng documents nyo, all you need to do now is pay for the application. Now, for the visa fee, nag-increase na kasi siya simula nung February 2nd. Again, this is also based from the new rule. So, for adults, ang kailangan na nilang bayaran is 80 euro. So, it's 4,510 Philippine peso. And for children naman, from age 6 to 11, ang babayaran nila is 40 euro, which is 2,260. And for children under 6 years old, lahat yan free of charge. Yun yung i-ready nyo na pera, guys. And on top of that, you would be required to pay a visa fee. So, iba yung, No. You will be needing to pay service fee. So, iba yung visa fee at saka iba yung service fee. So, ang service fee, if hindi ka children age under 6, ang babayaran mo is 870 on top of the visa application fee. Let's say, nabayaran nyo na, nakauwi na kayo, all you need to do now is to track your application and wait for the result. So, with this, either kunin nyo, pag, I think makaka-receive ka ng SMS, text, or ng email whether your application is okay na. Hindi nila sasabihin sa'yo actually kung approved or denied. Makikita mo lang kung approved or denied ka once na nakuha mo na yung passport mo. So, kayong bahala whether ipipick up nyo sa BLS yung passport nyo. And then, I think you also have an option na i-deliver na lang sa inyo. Pero, meron yung additional fee. So, yeah. I think I already mentioned everything. Again, guys, itong mga sinabi ko is for applicant for short-term visa ng tourist at saka ng visit visa only. Not long-term. I will be doing a different video for that. So, antay-antay na lang tayo. And I do hope that this video is helpful or may naintindihan kayo or mas naipaliwanag ko kung paano mag-apply for tourist at saka visit visa. If you do have any question, anything, please do have it in the comment section below. I'll try my best to answer everything. Or you can also send me a direct message, email me, or message me on Facebook. Also, guys, I do have a Facebook group. It's in the description below. Join that. So, again, guys, my website, all the services that I offer, it's in the description below. Now, I'll see you in my next video. Bye!